I'm sorry, Lieutenant, but whatever it is, you're going to have to take care of it yourself.
Oh, it's all right. It's just a scratch, really. You know, I like you better this way.
This is the emergency medical holographic system to Captain Janeway.
She's not on board. She's missing on the surface of a planet.
Missing. The captain is missing. It seems I found myself on the voyage of the damned.
He told me four people came today from Kalto. Two of them were a lot older than you, and they had a child with them.
Well, the attendant was wrong. That was us.
So, where's the child?
We ate him. Because we are demons, and we eat children, and I haven't had my supper yet. Sorry.
I'll see you then.
Don't worry, I'm not going to kiss you. I'm only adjusting the restraint.
I'll try to contain my disappointment.
Strange. According to my readings, you are not here.
Believe me, I wish I weren't. I'm curious, Captain. Exactly what are you looking for?
I need to know if we did serious harm to this life form.
Let's see. You ran your ship through it, fired phasers at it, and blew a hole in it with a photon torpedo. I'd say it's a pretty good chance that you did
something
fairly
significant. Computer, mute
audio. Is that final?
Dismissed. That's a Starfleet expression for get out.
That is a complete exaggeration. Just yesterday, I overhauled the servicing system.
Crewman, from this point on, you will speak only if you are spoken to.
But, Lieutenant, I'm just trying...
40 laps around the cargo bay. Start running now.
But...
50 laps.
Awful. How can you eat it?
I can't stop eating it. I've had 6 bowls.
And the reason it tastes so strange, I put a container of nitrogenated soil in it.
Dirt? You're eating dirt? Okay, all right. Far be it from me to bother anyone. If you really want me to leave, I'll leave.
I really want you to leave.
I don't believe you. Your voice says go away. But your heart wants me to make you smile.
Please, go away.
Come on! A little smile! How is it gonna hurt? I won't tell anyone.
What must I do to convince you to stop?
Come on, just a little itty-bitty smile. Just let the mouth curl a little then.
We could have worn our Starfleet uniforms. I doubt if anyone would have noticed.
This entire region sank under 200 meters of water. It became one of the world's largest coral reefs, home to thousands of different marine species.
Some interesting species in this century.
My name is Tom Paris, by the way.
Rain Robinson.
Your curves don't look so great.
Excuse me? What the hell did you do to my computer? It is screwed up. The hard drive is wiped.
Look, I don't have time to explain.
Who are you people, and what is that thing in your pants?
I beg your pardon.
That little gadget you put in your pocket, what is it?
I've been equipped with an autonomous, self-sustaining mobile holo emitter. In short, I am footloose and fancy-free.
Guys who have disappeared into thin air on the first date.
I assume she is speaking figuratively.
But I have never actually seen it happen. And you, Mr. Leisure Suit.
There's a name I hadn't considered.
That guy punched. Talk about a motley crew. We have the doctor, a guy with the worst, worst taste in clothing I've ever seen. Tuvok, what a freakosaurus. Has the guy ever cracked a smile?
Not that I can recall.
And you, Tom Paris. Sexy, in a howdy-doody sort of way.
God in heaven help us.
Divine intervention is unlikely.
Given Mr. Paris's alleged familiarity with 20th century America, it is a wonder we survived the experience at all.
Tuvok, has anyone ever told you you're a real freakosaurus?
Your instincts were correct. However, one day your intuition will fail, and you will finally understand that logic is primary above all else. Instinct is simply another term for serendipity.
And one day, Mr. Vulcan, I'll get you to trust your gut.
That is doubtful.
We'll see.
Your attempts have yet to succeed.
You always have to get in that last word, don't you?
I am simply responding to your erroneous statement.
Something tells me you just hate to lose an argument.
Losing is irrelevant.
See what I mean?
No, I do not.
You should have let us die.
I couldn't do that.
This drone cannot survive outside the collective.
I beg to differ. Now that the Borg implants are being excised, your human systems are free to thrive. And thriving they are. As a matter of fact, I...
It is acceptable.
Fashion, of course, is hardly my forte. Nevertheless, I've managed to balance functionality and aesthetics in a pleasing enough manner. I also took the liberty of stimulating your hair follicles. A vicarious experience for me, as you might imagine. Rock. You haven't been following the relaxation regimen I prescribed for you.
I've been too busy.
The usual story. Have you been getting enough sleep?
More or less. Mostly less.
Mm-hmm. And have your headaches been getting any worse?
No. They're not getting any better either. They're like hot needles driving into my skull.
These symptoms are hardly surprising, Captain. You work absurdly long hours under constant stress, eating on the run, without sufficient exercise or rest. Your body is crying out for mercy.
It certainly is right now. There must be some easier way to do this, Doctor. A hypo spray, maybe?
Always looking for the simple fix. Sometimes there's no substitute for intensive osteopathic pressure therapy. Then what's this all about?
I've learned from observing Lieutenants Taurus in Paris that humans sometimes require a pretext for being intimate with one another.
Intimate?
Resistance is futile.
Deck six. I've got a hunch Harry's dreaming about our new alien friend.
That would be consistent with the experiences the rest of us have had.
Tell me more about your dream. Where exactly did you see the alien?
As a matter of fact, it was here in the turbolift.
What happened?
The alien simply stared at me as if scrutinizing my appearance.
That's what happened in my dream. What did you do?
I returned to my quarters.
Did the alien follow you?
He did.
And then?
He watched me.
Doing what?
Getting dressed.
Getting dressed?
Yes.
I don't suppose I should ask why you were undressed.
I would prefer that you didn't.
Mr. Vulcan, sir. A tactical question, if I may?
You may.
We're just about done rebuilding the internal security sensors, and we're ready to program the audio signal. Do you want it to say, intruder alert? Or should we try something a little more dramatic, like warning, intruder alert? Or, intruders among us, danger!
Danger! Intruders among us!
Intruder alert. We'll suffice.
Go with the classic. Understood, sir.
And you believe you have difficulties?
I'm as close to a sentient life form as any hologram could hope to be. I socialize with the crew, fraternize with aliens. I've even had sexual relations.
Sex? How's that possible? We're not equipped.
Let's just say I made an addition to my program.
Before you leave, maybe you could download those subroutines into my database.
We'll see.
Engaged. Is your body armor designed to handle rapid pressure fluctuations?
It can defeat most hostile environments. I once tracked a silicon-based life form through the neutronium mantle of a collapsed star.
I once tracked a mouse through Jeffrey's tube 32.
Six of ten, this is not your assignment.
Please, stop calling me that.
You are compromising our productivity. I am reassigning you to chamber maintenance. Your new designation is 2 of 10.
Wait a minute. You're demoting me? Since when did the Borg pull rank?
A Starfleet protocol I adapted. I find it most useful.
Captain Proton to Buster Kincaid. I've destroyed Dr. Chaotica's mind control machine, and I'm on my way back to the spaceship.
Hello, Proton.
Who is this?
An old friend. Make that 2 old.
I present Her Royal Highness, Arachnia.
At last, my queen.
Friends, together we could conquer the universe. End this madness, and you may yet live to be my bride.
The shield. I don't know how to tell you this. But the wedding's off.
What about my other duties?
Make sickbay your priority. At this point, morale is a luxury. How's the core holding up?
The modified nanoprobes are still reinforcing the warp field. It should remain functioning until we reach the demon planet. However, there is less than a 20% probability that Voyager will remain intact that long.
Well, it won't be the first time this crew has been... off again.
Captain. Through the years, to a time when you were younger, a child. Is there something amusing, Lieutenant?
I'm sorry, an image just flashed through my mind. You as a child, those pointy little ears. You must have been cute.
Indeed. Please.
You are correct. I have been observing you as part of my research on human mating behavior.
Stardate 52647, 1400 hours. Subjects quarrel in corridor outside female's quarters. Male returns with 12 flowering plant stems, species Rosa rubifolia, effecting a cessation of hostilities. Stardate 52648, 0300 hours, intimate relations resume. How the hell do you know when we're having intimate relations?
There is no one on Deck 9, Section 12, who doesn't know when you're having intimate relations.
Is there a problem?
I want all the data you've collected.
I haven't completed the study.
Then study this. Borg provokes Klingon. Klingon breaks Borg nose.
B'Elanna?
Call sickbay. Tell them there's about to be a medical emergency.
B'Elanna, let's go ahead.
You are my sunshine, my only sunshine. You make me happy when skies are gray.
You'll never know, dear,
how much I love you. Please don't take my sunshine away.
Stand back! He's been seized by the Pon Farr. A neurochemical imbalance is driving him to mate. We won't be able to reason with him.
Tuvok, I understand. You are a Vulcan man. You have just gone without for 7 years about. Paris, please find a way to load a hypospray. I will give you the sign. Just aim for his behind. Hormones are raging. Synapses blazing. It's all so very illogical.
This mission is starting to look a little more dangerous than we thought. Maybe we do need the doctor to come along. If one of us fell through the crust, there could be injuries.
I require the doctor's assistance in astrometrics.
What for?
That's none of your business.
I think it is.
Oh. What's wrong, Captain?
It's nothing really. An old academy injury. Flares up every now and then. I've learned to live with it. But maybe you should stay here and have a look. Right? There. Get away from him!
You are dismissed.
Doctor?
Can I ask you something else, Harry?
Please.
Would you like to kiss me?
Is that a trick question?
Holy Mother of God!
Tom! Don't you have anything better to do?
They're always looking for laborers at the power distribution plant.
I had a job there once. Didn't like it much.
Odd. They treat their employees well. How long were you there?
Oh, a while.
It would be very simple for me to find out.
A day.
A day?
Half a day, actually, give or take an hour.
Not what I call an illustrious career.
I don't belong behind a console pushing buttons. But when I heard some of the workers talking about your place, I knew I had to get a job here.
You were terminated, weren't you?
Yes.
Oh, that's quite an accomplishment during a labor shortage. What happened?
Oh, it's a long story.
I like a long story.
I had a disagreement with the new efficiency monitor. She didn't think my work was very...
efficient?
Exactly.
Then why should I hire you?
Well, there's my natural charm and personality. They'd be a real asset around a place like this where you're trying to attract patrons. I mean, look at you. You haven't been able to tear yourself away from me.
There's no one else here.
Please. I really need the work.
You better clean those tables over there. This place is going to be filled with hungry workers as soon as the next shift ends.
You won't regret this.
Oh, I'm certain I will.
Paris to... Paris to sick bay. It's time.
Remain calm, Mr. Paris. Can she stand?
Affirmative.
Then I suggest you report to sick bay.
What about B'Elanna?
Her too.
Right, of course. Maybe we should take the transporter. Hey, wait for me!
Try to relax, Lieutenant.
Oh, if you tell me to relax one more time, I'm gonna rip your holographic head off!
I hope you don't intend to kiss your baby with that mouth.
Tell me this isn't...
What do you want?
You'll pay for your deceit, Kaicha! The House of Karrath won't rest until you drown in your own blood!
I'd love to stay in chat, but I'm on a tight schedule. Computer warp 6.
If you're going to emit that tachyon ship, beam, ship it down to the ship, and we'll ship it out of here.
Here goes.